Welcome. Today we will discuss about capacitor. This is symbol of capacitor. Now impedance of this capacitor is written by 1 by C omega, where omega is equal to 2 pi f. F is the frequency of the voltage applied across this capacitor. You see, if F is more, or if frequency is more, this omega is more, so this total value will come down, or impedance will come down. So higher the frequency, impedance of this C will be less. I have written one more Z in vector form. That is equal to 1 by J C omega. This is used when we do vector calculation. But numerical value of this vector is still 1 by C omega. See, this value is same as this. Only J is added, J is vector. Here I have shown one simple circuit. A DC voltage source. One resistance 10k, a switch, a capacitor 1000 micro. When we close the switch, current will flow and this capacitor will charge. Now capacitor behavior is like that, in the beginning it shows short. So when we close the switch, this will be short, so current flowing in this will be this voltage divided by this resistance, about 0.9 milliampere. Now when current flows, this capacitor will start charging. So in the beginning, voltage across this capacitor will be 0. This is voltage line, this is current line. So voltage will be 0, a current will be maximum. As soon as it will charge with time, voltage across capacitor will increase slowly, a current in this will start reducing, because when capacitor will charge here, voltage across this resistance will come down and current will reduce. So after closing switch, we see voltage will increase and current in capacitor will come down slowly. I will show a practical showing this. This is setup, this battery is this, this resistor is this, this capacitor is this, this multimeter will read current, this multimeter will read voltage across capacitor. When I will switch this switch on, this will show maximum current, slowly current will reduce, and here voltage will increase slowly. Now I am switching on, I have switched on, see current is high, current is coming down. Here voltage is going up. So this is this and this is this. Slowly current is coming down. Now time constant is about 10k into 1000 micro. About 10 seconds. Now you see earlier this voltage was increasing fast. Now it is increasing slowly because we are here. Similarly current, earlier it was coming down fast, but now it is coming down slowly because we are here. This is almost full charge. Now I will open this switch. See, switch I have opened, but capacitor voltage is still there because it is holding voltage. It is holding the charge. Now it can discharge using external resistance or internal leakage resistance. So it has internal leakage resistance. All capacitor will be having. So it is discharging very slowly. You see, voltage across this is coming down slowly. This is because of discharge due to internal resistance in this capacitor. If I connect one resistor here, it will discharge faster. Here I have connected capacitor across AC voltage. When we do like this, current will flow. Now here I have shown wave shape of voltage and current both. Now voltage across capacitor and source will be same, that is shown by red color. A current flowing in the capacitor is shown in green color. Now in the case of capacitor, current will always lead compared to voltage. What is meaning of leading? You see here, this green color is current and red color is voltage, and time is moving like this. This is peak of current. Here current is less, here current is maximum. So this is peak. Here peak of voltage. So when you move with time, first current peak will come, then voltage peak will come. Because first current peak is coming, we call current is leading. So in capacitor, when AC is connected, current will lead with respect to voltage, and it will lead 90 degree. Now some time back we discuss, when there is a DC voltage here and we switch on the switch and heavy current will flow in the capacitor, and that current is limited by a resistor. Now suppose the resistor itself is not there, then very heavy current will flow, whether it is DC or AC. So because of this heavy current, this switch will damage. In industry what happens, many cases we switch capacitor using a relay contact or a conductor contact. So this contact will fail very frequently, so they will replace it. But still they will use conductor or relay because that is very cheap. Another method of switching capacitor is with AC zero current switching method. In this case, instead of contact, we use triac or thyristor. And there will be control circuit which will send zero current, and when current is not flowing, then only it will switch. That time system will work very well, but this will be expensive. Now we come to applications. First application is low pass filter. Here one R is there and C is there. This behave as a low pass filter, means lower frequency component will pass and higher frequency will filter out. Because at higher frequency, this impedance will be low. So current will flow like this. And this RC will have some cutoff frequency. Similarly, this has another application, high pass filter. In this, C is here. In high pass, C will be here, resistance will be here. High pass means high frequency should pass. So when high frequency component comes, this for high frequency, this impedance will be low. So it will pass. At lower frequency, this impedance will be high. So draw will be high. So it will attenuate. So this is called the high pass filter, this is called the low pass filter. This low pass filter is used many places to filter noise also. Then one application is DC power supply. This is rectifier. I have not shown full. At output of the rectifier, when high value of electrolytic capacitor are connected. So this will store the energy. When load current flows, voltage drop or fluctuation here will be less. I have written 10,000 micro, but it may be some other value also, depending upon the load current. Then the noise filter. In PCBs, power supply will be there. There will be so many ICs. So in power supplies, small spikes will come. That is called the noise. To filter those spikes or noise, so many small value of capacitors are used. Now another application is power factor improvement. What happens when we connect a load? Generally load will have R also and inductance L also. Because of this inductance, a reactive current will flow like this. Because of reactive current, power factor will come down. To improve that, we connect a capacitor. This capacitor characteristics and inductor characteristics are reverse in nature. So they will cancel out and power factor will improve. If we don't improve power factor, unnecessary current will flow. That will burden wire also and source also. Another application is series capacitor. This is also called series compensator. What happens? Power transmission is done using high voltage line, maybe 220 kilovolt. There will be three lines. I have shown only one because transmission will be done using three phase. Now this wire will have resistance and inductance. This resistance and inductance is the value of R and L of this wire. It is not connected extra. Because of this L, transmission capacity of this transmission line comes down. To improve that, we connect a capacitor in series. This capacitor will cancel out this inductance and power transmission capacity of this transmission line will improve. This is ground. Now what is discharge resistance? Earlier we have seen when a power supply is removed from the capacitor, capacitor will remain charged. Now if power supply voltage is high, say 415 volt, then voltage across discharge capacitor will be high and that will be DC. That is very dangerous. It will not be visible also. Anybody can touch. To solve that problem, an external resistance is connected. That is called the discharge resistance or discharge resistor. You see here, this is capacitor. This capacitor is this capacitor. And this terminal and this terminal are these terminals. Here itself, outside the capacitor, one high value resistor is connected permanently. So when we remove the power supply, because of this resistance, this capacitor will discharge. This problem is more when capacitor value are more, say 10 kVAR. In smaller capacitor, it will discharge fast. But in bigger capacitor, it may take many hours. So this resistor is connected. That is called the discharge resistance. Today we will close here itself.